us, okay?
Just doing some bird impressions. None of them are crows, though, were they?
It's more of a pigeon.
Yeah, I'm better.
What's a crow like? He did ask for an impression of crow, right?
It's on camera, isn't it?
Good, that's you can use that.
Yeah. You can have that.
I'm Charlie from All About The Rock, and we're here with the guys from Evil Scarecrow. How are you today?
Lovely, thank you.
Very well, thank you, Charlie.
Excited for tonight?
Yes, thank you very much.
Yes.
I'm really excited for the game. I've never been to one of your gigs before.
Oh, God,
I've heard a lot about you. That's the main thing.
Yeah. Where did you hear about this one? On the internet and stuff?
No, from actual
newspaper.
People who's come to
oh,
see
okay,
you. From people who came to see you in the past. So.
Yeah.
And my girlfriend used to be in a band, so her dad's really into you, so... It's quite.
It's the older generation we try to pass the word down to their children.
Yeah, but can you tell me how did you guys originate? What was the? Because I've read your biography, but
no, I expect something new.
Like,
well,
where did we meet? For the paint, first of all.
Well, I met you in a saloon in
Texas. The Wild West.
Yes,
didn't we?
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
Right. Yeah,
and, I was out playing some craps.
Yeah,
that's a game, isn't it?
And I was one of the prostitutes.
And the only way we could have got out of a pickle was by us joining in a band.
That's right.
Long story short,
We joined a band in a Wild West 1853.
1853 it was, first gig,
First gig.
Played on a banjo and a washboard.
Yeah. It just got heavier and heavier over the years.
Over the last.
Influencing all music of all genres.
60 years.
Yeah.
No, actually, we knew each other from our hometown in Boston, Lincolnshire.
Yeah,
from that. Scrap that last answer. The first answer.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, because you came from Lincolnshire, how did it all come about that you came from Nottingham? What was that about?
I know Lincolnshire sucks balls. It's really racist.
We lots of people there.
Yeah. Oh, there isn't there.
Yeah.
Sorry, Lincolnshire. It's very nice.
We're not racist and we don't suck balls.
Lincolnshire's very flat and at some point raised up and we just rolled.
Well, I moved here first.
Mr. First, aren't you?
Moved here first.
Trendsetter.
And then slowly other members of the band. We used to have band practice in Boston, Lincolnshire.
Yeah.
We travelled back every bloody weekend, every Wednesday.
Yeah.
An hour and a half there, an hour and a half back. We would do that.
Mentalists.
Yes, we did that for ages. And then we just thought, what's how about we just based ourselves on Nottingham?
Yeah.
And that was it.
That's something like that. Mm. That's not entirely true. It's about right.
It's sort of vintage.
Yeah, it'll do.
Yeah.
It's good enough. It's good enough for the likes of you.
All I know is, like, Boston's on the way to Skeg.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, nothing to say. It's the best way to treat Boston is just to go through it, really.
Yeah.
Mm.
And it's got a McDonald's, so on the way to Skeg, you've got that McDonald's.
You do.
Stop off and carry on. So.
Beautiful place.
Oh,
Where did the name actually come from?
God, that's such a boring question. I hate that question.
Yeah, we've heard that one. Did the real answer?
Someone gave it to us.
We
bought it. We bought it.
We bought a domain, didn't we?
On the internet. I don't know.
We typed in Evil Scarecrow.
We typed in... No. We auction. It was at an auction. That was it.
So
it was at an auction in Surrey.
Surrey.
We went down to Surrey and there was auctioning off band names.
Yeah.
And that was the only one we could afford.
We needed 14 pence.
Yeah, that was it.
All the best ones went The Doors and the Police. They went
really quickly.
Yeah.
For a lot of money.
And we got this lot number 412, Evil Scarecrow. And it was everyone. Yeah.
In fact, wasn't it just a bin full of unknown names, wasn't it? So there's a bin of unknown band names. It's like that program, isn't it? Bin Hunters or whatever it's called.
Log it.
No, the one where they open up
Storage
Hunters.
Somewhere open storage, found a whole load of band names.
Yeah,
like,
we flogged these. We just kept that one.
Yeah. So even though we're called Evil Scarecrow, we've got loads of this.
It's full backup.
Yeah. Window Box.
Battalion.
Battalion. Yeah. Sledge Smith. Luke Skywalker and the.
Penis.
And the Ewok's penis, yeah.
Ewok's penis, yeah.
So you can call us any one of these names if you want to.
Yeah,
it's
all fine. Just make up a name and we'll probably answer to it.
We probably own it.
Yeah.
You've got your old dress up and also the stage show.
Mm.
Who comes up with the idea?
It's like a West End musical. You've got your dress up and your stage show. Oh, it's marvellous.
And you're going with me.
Who comes up with them ideas of...
Me. I take full credit for everything.
It isn't.
Okay, it's not really me. It's all of us.
It's a joint nonsense.
Yeah, it's like, you know, you got your bunch of mates. Mm. Imagine, and you all serve funny jokes, and everyone's got an in-joke. Ha, 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 ha. We're the same, but then we write a song about it.
Just turn the in-jokes into songs.
Yeah, into craft them into a beautifully silky song. Which
crafting. Good. That's yeah. That makes really sound. Put lots of effort in.
Yeah. Always crafting.
Yeah.
Crafting. So, yeah, it's just that kind of stuff. So we like to sing a song about. Like a robot. Oh, that'd be funny. That's funny. And then we'll like spin it into a silky crafted and we'll sell thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of copies of it in Woolworths.
Yeah, it isn't going anymore.
Yeah, all of our shares in Woolworths.
Yeah, no, exactly.
That's why we're going all of our money.
Yeah.
It's going alright though, isn't that our investment in Woolworths?
It's got websites.
Right, that's alright, isn't it?
Yeah, we're still
because he handles all the money, I'm just making sure.
Northern Rock, not Northern Rock. Yeah, Northern Rock, yeah.
That's alright,
I've got a lot of shares in there.
HMB Music stuff.
Yeah, that's all going fine.
Yeah. That's the video.
Yeah, well, that's video of the future, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, everyone's like, oh, I've got a camera or an iPad. Video, that's what people really want. Much like vinyl, video's going to be. So I put all the money into video, all into an E180 cassette tapes.
Nice.
What was the question about?
It
was
about. I know, we just go off at random. I don't know if we even really listen to questions now. We just make up an answer. Go on, ask us another question, we'll see how it goes.
Who are your main influences?
Well, we met 20 years ago. Who are our main influences? Oh, I don't know.
Opeth,
Judas
Priest, Judas
Iscariot,
Joanna Lumley, Liam Gallagher.
We love Liam Gallagher.
Yeah. Patsy Kensit. His wife.
Bobby Robson.
Len Gangley, the snooker player.
Dirty Dent, the character, not the actor who played.
Yeah. James Hewitt.
Cyndi Lauper. She's a musician.
The Queen, obviously the Queen.
The Queen, obviously, the royalists.
Yeah.
Bagpuss. five gold rings.
Just your general regular.
Heavy metal.
Heavy metal, yeah.
Name a heavy metal band, we'll tell you whether or not they've influenced us.
Heavy metal band, so, I don't know, Airborne?
Not really. We probably influenced them.
Heavy metal band, Slipknot?
No, we probably influenced
them as well, yeah.
In fact, it's just us, isn't it, really? We influence ourselves. Yeah.
You should be asking other bands that, like.
Yeah.
Tell me how Evil Scarecrow influenced.
Yeah, how much?
Yeah, actually a really good question. That'd be a Charlie's fun question. I've got some fun questions.
Oh, good.
All right.
Yeah.
So, what places has the band taken you to so far? Countries, or have you stayed in the UK?
No, we've gone to.
We've been to Germany
and Ibiza.
And
yeah,
Wales.
Have we played anywhere else?
No, that's it.
Is that it?
That's it. We haven't quite got over the border to Scotland yet.
No.
I think Preston.
Oh, we're playing Ireland this year, aren't we?
We are playing Ireland, yes.
Yeah.
I think we are, yeah.
Northern Ireland, or the Southern Ireland.
It's just Ireland. It's an island.
Yeah, so not played many abroad places, mostly because little old Craig Moore gets scared. Yeah. That's not too far away from his mum.
Oh, that's right, his home cooking.
You
never know, might do a European tour. I want to play Japan.
Yeah.
That'd be good.
Would be good.
But we need lots of money.
Yeah.
So if you can give us any money.
I can give you a Japanese band who I interviewed before.
Can we give us them?
Yeah, can we use them?
We've got to carry them around and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Like that. For the guitarist. Yeah. Try and get me on it.
Wow, I've never been given a band before. Fucking brilliant.
But I'm going to be brushing on the Ibiza road trip in like two questions.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah.
So, I mean, you've had two albums. Is it Crowfication?
No.
Again.
Crucification?
No.
What is it?
Keep trying.
Crow?
Think of Jesus.
Crucification. Oh,
no.
Crucifying.
Yes.
Maybe
almost.
No.
I can't say it.
No, you can.
Have you got it written down? Crucification.
That's not even right, that's not even. Did we write this?
Yeah.
What's this?
What is the album called?
And
Crucifixion.
Yeah, Crucifixion. So they're Crucifaction.
Yeah, I've got the wrong one.
Crucifixion.
That's what I can't see. So it's Crucifixion.
Crucifixion. Like Crucifixion.
And Crucifixion.
I hope I got this one right. 66 minutes past six.
Yes, that one's right.
And Helldog EP.
Yeah.
What influences did you have at the time when you came up with all these?
don't know, Chris Fitchin's so old, like, I can't even remember what we were doing.
Iron Maiden, mostly, I think that was for me. I just went to Iron Maiden when that album was written.
Helldog.
Helldog.
I don't know, was I don't know, who knows?
What your most recent album?
Most recent album is most 66. But the one that's coming out.
It's good, isn't it? Heavy metal. We influenced ourselves, we've already answered this.
Yeah,
we influenced ourselves, it was into ourselves, and that was it.
Yeah.
And everyone else followed us, really, so we wrote Helldog, and then people went back in time and wrote some heavy metal, didn't they?
Yeah, to follow up.
Well, I don't know, it's a really hard question. That's just a different question.
Okay.
What was related to leaving, going home?
You've obviously released your DVD last month.
Yeah.
Yes.
Lots of footage of Bloodstock.
Yes.
Yeah.
And backstage footage.
Mm-hmm.
How was production? How did it all go? And how long did it actually take to do the whole DVD?
Well, would you mean actually physically making it and put editing all the footage together?
Yes. Yeah.
Well, it took a little while. I did some of it and I cobbled together all the mobile crap that we'd gleaned over the years. But fortunately, we had loads of better footage.
Yeah.
Sat on various devices.
Mm-hmm. My iPhone, which is
your
in the toilet.
Which is in a toilet somewhere.
In Wales.
Your iPad,
which is on top of a car. Well, it was on top of a car and stolen by some scally in Forest Fields.
Yeah, if you stole an iPad in Forest Fields, bring it back.
It's my UF.
Brother Payne's. And the other one got broken by the Mediterranean.
Let's see.
Sorry. Oh, hello, Monty.
Hello there.
Monty's here.
I'm going to have to really sort of... There's
John,
Monty at the top of my head.
Sorry. Get out of it.
Sorry.
Oh.
I thought that was quite well done.
No,
it was rubbish.
Okay, sorry.
What else was... Oh, yes, the question was about how long to build it, take the...
So, I don't know.
Between
weeks.
August and December.
Yeah, it was a few weeks.
Yeah.
Pissing about, and then the other chaps did the live stuff and the mixing and that.
Mm.
It was good, though. It was a good experiment. You know, a lot of people have been asking for it, so we thought, why not?
Mm.
Be a giggle.
Yeah,
it was a good show as well, we had a lot of fun.
Yeah, a lot of people enjoyed that one. Have you
sold lots of copies?
We've sold over a million.
Over a million. We've just broken over 1 million.
I know, can you imagine
a
million?
It's amazing, isn't it? Yeah.
I haven't actually seen it yet, but
you
I looked at the trailer on your website, I'm thinking right after.
Well, a million.
Sure, that's not a million at all.
She doesn't know that.
You have sold 1 million.
Well, yeah, a million is one in seven people who got it in England.
That's Jordan. Jordan, how many DVDs have we sold, mate?
Who's Jordan?
Monty, how many DVDs have we sold?
A million, isn't it?
A million, that's proof, that's evidence. You can't prove otherwise now.
Yeah.
That's where I've just been, crunching the numbers. Crunching the DVD.
And where are our suspicions of them being just over a million, about right?
A million two.
Well, a million and two, there you go. That's exact figures.
How many tickets have we sold for this gig tonight?
Million
two.
A million, I thought it was
a million. Yeah, about a million, yeah.
Cool, that's good.
By the way, really bad at numbers and maths.
You've played Bloodstock in 2008, 2011, 2013, also you're set to return again this year. You've also played the Ibiza Rave Party, Hammerfest, and did you play the pre-party at the Metal Hammer Club?
We played on the boat, yes. Good research, well done.
How does it feel to be like performing at such big events in the metal calendar and having the privilege of being on the similar stage to...
Well, undeserved.
Yes. Totally. I couldn't agree more.
Yeah.
Good answer. But we only started, like we always say this, don't we? We only started the band for a laugh.
Yeah.
We still do it mostly for a laugh. So to get anywhere and play anywhere, really, even just shitty little bars that let us through their door and make a mess of their corner, like a naughty dog. We're always a
stand. Yeah, it does seem odd that we'd only started this as a stupid, fun thing. Oh, look, we're doing a silly band. And then Metal Hammer's like, can you play the Golden Gods Awards? I'm like, what? Isn't no one else out there you could find?
Are you desperate?
Yeah. But it's been going all right, so I guess we must be okay, I guess.
I think a lot of it as well is our silly following of nutty fans, isn't it?
Mm.
Did you see the fondant Krabulon?
No.
I was going to check out the Facebook page. Someone's made a crabulon out of fondant icing. We've got a new backdrop today. Which
that's
is, you know,
yes.
The artwork for that was done by a fan.
What's his name?
I can't remember. Matt.
Matt.
Maybe. I don't know. No, I can't remember. I spoke to him all week and now I've forgotten. Now you remember like a fool. Thanks a lot, Brother Payne.
You know.
Scott Tenneman. He's called Scott Tenneman.
have you had... Right. It might be a silly question, but have you had any memorable moments throughout your band career so far?
None.
No funny moments on stage.
No,
nothing's ever happened.
No, absolutely nothing. No.
It just has been like turning up, go to work. It's been like going to work.
Yeah, it's been like saying, what's the funniest story you've had about filing?
Yeah,
nothing happens.
Tell me the craziest sleep you ever had.
Yeah.
No, loads of fun, haven't we? Yeah. Loads of fun. That time when.
You left your iPad on top of lost your phone down the toilet.
Yeah.
That was pretty funny.
At that time when Craig and Morty tried to do a pool my head once, it was half asleep and he almost did a pool my head. But you'll hear more about that in my book, which is coming out.
But that was a different time to when he was unconscious on the floor with his arse out.
Was it a different time?
It was a different time, yeah.
I thought he ended up on the floor with his arse out.
No, it was a different time because... Mm. That time, I think I was asleep in the van. I didn't know about it.
Oh.
The other time was when I was asleep in the doghouse because that's when I stood in here.
Yeah, what happened was
I thought it might be a pizza.
Oh, I'm allowed to tell this story. We were allowed to tell
this. I don't know. Maybe we should.
No, okay.
No, nothing funny has happened. We'll stick with that. Nothing funny has happened or ever will happen.
Nothing.
God, I want to hear the story now.
No, it's all poo related. You know what I mean?
It's all poo related. Yeah.
You know, we're trying to raise our game a bit. We're trying to be a bit. We've bought a new backdrop. Let's not go back to talking about poo again. It's always poo.
Is the basically, is there anything you can tell us about? Anything up and coming? Any albums? Any new albums?
Yeah,
tell all about the new albums. We're doing a new album.
Oh, we thought I was doing a horse racing.
Yeah, I was trying to, but
it's hard, isn't it?
Yeah. When's it coming out? We don't know, do we?
We don't know, but it will be this year. We've got another session in the studio at the end of the week.
We have not yes, in a few weeks' time.
Yes.
Is that all the recording done by then?
No. Most of it, though, will be done by then.
Mm.
So, yes, it's in production, and
it
will
written.
Be soon.
Words are written.
Most of the words are written,
Solos are all...
Well, so you solos, you just bring them out last minute, don't you?
Exactly.
No one writes a solo, you just go... Do it on the spot.
Well, I'm going to go down to an auction and see if there's any solos for sale.
Yeah, we should. See if we get a box full of solos.
Box full of knackered old solos.
Yeah, knackered old solos. Yeah,
used like. Solos.
Yeah.
There is a solo that Kirk Hammett wasn't going to use on the 1986 album.
That'd be a bit good though, wouldn't it? We need something even worse, really.
Okay,
this is some unknown guitarist. Bob Smith from cover band David and the Coverdales. this solo from his, you know, his single solo project, and he put it in the bin. Is that bad?
Yeah,
along with a load of other his solos. £10 a box.
£10 a box.
Hours,
oh,
thank you very much. Album's written.
Yeah. Copy and paste them into it.
Yeah.
That's what we'll do.
You just sent them to the bin. Yeah. A bit of solos on there. Just juggle it about a bit.
Yeah.
Shake them, screen a bit. Bosh.
Yeah.
They all fall into place.
Yeah,
that's it. Give them a nudge. Tell Russ Russell to get on with our producer. It's all done.
Yeah. And then bash. Hello, Russ Russell, in case you're watching this.
Hi, Russ.
He is, and he's so much more important than we are.
He is, yeah. Never
supposed
to be watching this. Yeah. Fuck off, actually. Bastard.
Do you think you have an estimated time when it could be out?
This year.
Just this year. Cool, that's fine.
This year. We'll give you an exclusive, alright?
Yeah.
Soon.
Soon.
Win.
Is it? Are we going to get it done before Bloodstock?
Yes.
Are we? We are. We're going to do it before Bloodstock.
Mm-hmm.
And after now, so between the 11th of January and the 14th of August,
something like that.
Yeah.
Sometime in August.
August, September, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August. That's only an 8-month window. You can't even have a baby in that time.
Yeah.
There you go. Our album will be ready in more time it takes to have a baby.
Less time.
Unless it's premature. Less time.
Yeah.
Than it takes to have a baby.
Yeah.
Unless it's premature.
So if you get pregnant tonight after watching our show, your little baby will listen to the album when it's born.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Try and get pregnant, Charlie.
I don't know how I'm going to get pregnant, but...
Well, there's your challenge for tonight, Charlie, and we want to know by the end of the day whether you've done it or not. Or at least tried.
I'll help.
Are you going to father it?
Yeah.
Final serious question, then it's Charlie's fun questions.
Oh, good.
So the final one is there anything you'd like to say to your fans who have followed you the whole way through, and also people that may have never heard of you?
To all our fans and followers, thank you. You are brilliant and crazy.
Yes,
what would we do without you?
to the new fans, where the fuck have you been, you lazy bastards?
Yeah,
why stop are you mucking this, about.
Why are you watching this video about a band you never heard of as well?
Yeah, what are you doing? Do. Are you that bored? You just having to watch stuff about people you don't even know? No, well, no, fuck you, we don't want you.
Documentary on paper filing.
Yeah.
I've watched that, and I watched a documentary on a band I've never heard of. Yeah. If you're watching that because of that, for that reason, they don't even want
you. No, we don't even want you. Just get out of it.
Just leave.
Just fuck you and your mum and your parents.
But if you're watching it because they've heard of us, but maybe they're...
Well, if you're checking us out, yeah, that's fine. That's totally
fine. That's totally fine. Yeah, so that's cool, man. Cool.
Yeah, you're all cool.
Yeah, thanks.
So, we're on to Charlie's fun questions.
Fucking time.
Yes!
What is your favourite alcoholic beverage?
Banana, toffee, waffle, ice cream, gin. No, actually, I don't know. I'm drinking Brooklyn Lager at the minute. Do you want to try that? It's quite nice.
I'm drinking a glass of white wine, which is nearly finished, but you can have the tiny little drink at the bottom. Will you enjoy that?
I'm getting...
What is this?
Brooklyn Lager. It's American. I'm getting eggs, spatter, breeze block, and... petunias. Would you like to try my Brooklyn Lager? Yeah,
that's right, it's quite nice. It went in my eye.
No.
Is that supposed to happen?
Yeah, that's...
it's not bad,
yeah, isn't it? Bad, isn't it? Yeah.
It's not bad.
So we'll go with that. That's our favourite drink.
Yeah, Brooklyn Lager.
How much is that downstairs?
I got it free because I'm a famous rock star.
That's fine.
Didn't need to pay for it.
If you could be any comic book superhero for a day, if you want it for a day, you can have it for a lot much longer. Who would you be and why?
Well, it's got to be
Asbestos Lady.
Asbestos Lady,
yes.
Asbestos Lady,
yes. Asbestos
Lady, yeah. It exists. It's genuine...
Well, she's
Marvel,
a villain, wasn't
was
she? Marvel, I think she was Marvel.
Marvel, yeah. Genuine Marvel super villain.
She had a cape of asbestos and a gun, and she used to burn shit down, and then like, asbestos cape, I am safe.
Yeah. Check it out, Asbestos Lady, was it?
Asbestos Lady, yes.
Asbestos Lady, she was a lady as well. Not just girl, not like Supergirl. What
Supergirl,
crap is
yeah.
That?
Yeah, or Spider Girl or whatever. Asbestos Lady, she
Asbestos
was a
lady.
Lady.
There you go, and we'd both be her. I'd be the top half.
I'd be the tits.
You'd be the
vagina.
The vagina
on the arse.
That
the
could
tits.
Be the vagina, couldn't be a little bit in there, look.
That could be the vagina.
That could be the vagina, yeah, I'll be the top half.
Yeah, you'd be the tits.
I'll be the tits. You'd
be
the vagina.
Okay.
Final question. If you could have any car for a day, or any car in the world, for however long you want it, what would it be?
It'd be my own Ford Mondeo, because I've already got insurance for it. I wouldn't have to bother like getting insurance for the new car.
That would be easier. I'd like a golden Volvo. Golden Volvo.
Okay.
Do you a golden vulva?
Yeah.
Golden, you misunderstood the question.
Golden Volvo. Golden Volvo, automatic, 1.9, petrol, 2002 reg.
Okay.
Four Sweet. Star petrol though, not unleaded.
Yeah.
Four star.
Yeah. What's four star petrol?
Oh, you're so young.
That is stuff that you had back
in the
day. Back in
when?
Back in the day.
And one final thing you'd like to do, possibly, is saying to the camera, we are Evil Scarecrow and you're watching All About The Rock TV.
All About The Rock TV?
Yeah.
All About The Rock TV. We're Evil Scarecrow, you're watching All About The Rock TV.
You're watching All About The Rock TV.
You're all about
watching The Rock TV.
Okay, let's do it. We're good, but we'll just do it.
What?
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
We're Evil Scarecrow and you're watching All About The Rock TV.
You're All About The Rock TV. You're The Rock. Can you smell what The Rock's cooking?
Oh, everything.